तो हेलो एवरीवन, प्रज्वल दिस साइड। लेट्स डिस्कस अ वेरी सिंपल प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम जीएफजी फॉर द लिंक्ड लिस्ट सेक्शन। ओके, सो लेट मी गो टू द प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट फर्स्ट। गिवन अ लिंक्ड लिस्ट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ एल नोड्स एंड अ गिवन नंबर एन, द टास्क इज टू फाइंड द एनथ नोड फ्रॉम द एंड ऑफ द लिंक्ड लिस्ट। सो लेट मी काइंड ऑफ एक्सप्लेन दिस। Like you can see here, for example, this linked list. Now we would be given a number n, and actually we need to find the nth node from the end in this linked list. In this case, suppose n is 2 and this linked list is 1 to 9. This from the end, what would be the first node from the end? Ninth one. What would be the second node? Eighth. So in this case, our answer is 8. If n were 3, then it would be 7 and 4, then 6, whatever. So the thing is, we have to find the nth node from the end. I hope the problem statement is clear. You can read the explanation part as well. But yeah, this was a pretty simple explanation, and let's go to the approach how we can do this. Okay, guys, so I have taken the example of this linked list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now in this example, my n is 3, means we have to find the third node from the end. Third node means 6, it would be the first node, 5, it would be the second, and 4, it would be the third. So let's discuss how to do this question. So my first approach would be, I would kind of, what I thought would be an initial approach would be, let's store all these elements in an array. Okay, so yeah, that's my array. So what I did was, actually, what simply I just take an iterator p, suppose, on the starting of this node, and I travel up to this up to the last node. That is when this iterator becomes up to the point when this p becomes null. Simply by making p to be equal to p's next. Simply we have this part in linked list. Now this next pointer is actually the address of the you can say that it contains the address of this. You must be knowing this before also. Yeah, so by simply, you can say, in the while loop, and until the p becomes null, we iterate this linked list up to the end, and we store all these members in the array. So we can get the size of this array as well, very easily. And yeah, so as I told, that we have to find the third node from the end. So simply, suppose, take the length, actually here 6, to be L. L minus N. Simply, directly we will get the index of that element. Like what I am doing is, I am actually finding out the index of that element. Now index of this of that element that we have to find, actually. So that would be simply my L, and that is length. In this case, our length is 6, minus the nth, or you can say the third node here. Third, we get third. So actually, the element that we have to found that we have to find is present on the third index. So this would be my zeroth index, my first index, second, and yeah, third one. So you can directly verify also from the last. It is actually first. This is the first, second, and the third node from the end, or you can say the third, or you can say the third index पर जो नोड है, दैट थर्ड इंडेक्स पर जो एलिमेंट है, बेसिकली दैट यू कैन से सिंपली वी आर स्टोरिंग इट इन एरे, एंड डायरेक्टली वी आर फाइंडिंग द एल माइनस एनथ. वी आर डायरेक्टली रिटर्निंग द एल माइनस एनथ इंडेक्स ऑफ दिस एरे. नाउ वट इज द प्रॉब्लम विद दिस अप्रोच इज, वी आर एक्चुअली टेकिंग एन ऑर्डर ऑफ एन ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस, यू कैन से. सो कैन कांट वी डू इट इन ऑर्डर ऑफ वन स्पेस. Let's make another approach. Like with this approach, we can find out the third. Like, why shouldn't we directly, you can say, directly L minus nth node from the starting? Why can't we find this? That is also pretty simple. That in that way, we don't need to store it in this array, and we will directly find out the L minus nth node from the starting. That as we are traveling up to the end, why shouldn't we travel up to L minus n only, and we will return this particular node's data, you can say. That is a pretty simple, I guess. So let's try this also. Okay, yeah. So let's try the O1 approach, O1 space approach, you can say. So here's my pointer peak, you can say. So as I told you before also that I'm going to basically find the L minus nth node, you can say. I'm going to return the nodes data. Initially, let's take my count. Let's take a count value to be 1 initially. Now what I'm going to do is L is the length of this linked list. Now if we, you know, try this sort of one approach, we would not be knowing L initially, because L, how in the previous case while we were storing the element, we can find the length of this array also. We can find the length of that array, and we came to know about the length of the total number of elements, you can say. But as we are given, as in this approach, we will not be storing it in an array. So to find out the length also, we have to, you know, kind of make a function, or by directly the same approach as I told you, like p equal to p is next, p equal to p is next inside the while loop until the p becomes null. And we will take a length variable. That length variable would be initially 1. Initially that length variable would be 1. Now as this would be in the while loop, we will do L plus plus. And after that while loop ends, that is when the, you can say, the p becomes null, that loop would stop, and we will find out the length of this. That is pretty much simple to find out the length of this array. And what we have to do actually in this question is, as I told you before, we have to return the data of the n minus nth node from the starting. Actually, so it means that nth node from the end can be found out by the l minus n iterations from the starting. Actually, that's not the n minus 1th node. Actual formula for the starting one would be L minus N plus 1. The nth node from the end is actually L minus N plus 1th node from the starting. But that one is not needed here, because we are actually, that L minus N is sufficient, because actually what we have to do is, we can iterate L minus N times from the starting, you can say. Like for example, here L is 6, N is 3, so equal to 3 we get. So it means 3 iterations from the starting. My first iteration would be from 1 to 2. Okay, so my second iteration would be this. And that's my third iteration. After that I will stop and return the data of this node. Pretty much simple. But from the starting, if we talk about it, is actually the L minus 1th node. You can say the L minus N plus 1 would be 4. So first, second, third, fourth node. Actually, it's the fourth node from the starting. But if we talk about the iterations, it is actually 3 iterations from the starting. So I guess that's a little bit confusion. It would have been a little bit confusion, but I guess I had cleared it all. Yeah, so it's actually the L minus N iterations from the starting. So simply, as I told you how to find the length, simply also we can make p to be head. The head node is actually this one, you can say, the head node. And that simply we can, inside the while loop, we can just do the, you can say, L minus N iterations. Wait a second. So yeah, here's my node, and simply I will take p pointer, a pointer p or whatever you like, on the head, and simply I can do L minus N, that is in this case 3 iterations. The simple concept, as I told, that inside the while loop you can write p to be p is next, and the condition, the terminating condition, you can say inside the while loop, you can write to be that simply x minus minus, where x is actually the L minus N, you can say, L minus N. So I guess that was pretty simple. We have discussed the two approach. One, the first one was to store inside the array and directly return the L minus Nth index of that array. And the second approach is, why should we store? We try to optimize it. So why should we store it in this array? We can directly do the L minus Nth iterations from the starting, and we can directly go to this particular node. Now what if our N is greater than our length of the linked list? Like suppose here is length is 6, so what if N is 7? So obviously in that case x would be minus 1. So this case is actually not possible. Like, how could we find the seventh node from the end? It does not have significance. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. The seventh node does not exist from the end. So if our n is greater than n, we have to simply return minus 1 in that case. That was also given in the question. So yeah, I hope I was clear in this regard. And yeah, this was our question. Now as the approach is clear to all, so let's now go through the code as well for more clarity. So yeah, on GFG we need to complete this function get nth node from the last. So we were given the head pointer and the n value. Let's take an iterator p, initialize it with head. So first step would be to find the length of the linked list, and as I told you, like, initially we will initialize it with the size to be 1, because we are on the presently on the first node, so obviously in that case size is 1. And we will iterate up to the last node, and the condition would be p is next not becomes null up to the and yeah, we will be incrementing sizes side by side, and after this loop ends we will get the size of this linked list. And as I told you before, like, when n or the given value that was given is greater than the length of the linked list, in that case this we will return minus 1, because this particular case does not have any significance. Okay, so yeah, if this is not the case, we will find out the starting, we will find how many times we have to, you can say, iterate from the starting point, and it would be size minus n. Size is the length minus n, so count times we have to iterate from the starting. So we will again initialize p with head, and this is the loop, and after that we will reach to the required node and we will return its data. Pretty much simple, I guess. So I hope it was clear. Okay, so let's discuss the third approach for this problem, a little optimized approach, I guess. Yeah, so before explaining that approach, let me kind of take an example, and that would be helpful for us for understanding this problem, or you can say this approach. So my problem, or you can say the example, is I have taken two runners A and B, and I'm considering that B runner has started before A. B has started, but A is not started yet. So B has covered, when B has covered k kilometers, you can say, or n kilometers, whatever, k, I'm taking k kilometers. After that, at that moment when B has covered k kilometers, then A has started. So it means initially when A has started, the difference of distance between both of them is k, and the condition is both are running at same speed. So it means that when B is reached from here to here, A must be here, because the both are running at same speed. So at every point of interval, the distance between both of them would be same, that is k. So here also difference would be k kilometers at every point. So I mean to say, when B is here, at some point of time it will reach here. So A would be here, k distance. So as both of them are running at same speed, so can we just relate this problem or approach with our case? What was our case? Our case was that we have to find the nth node from the linked list, from the last. We have to find the nth node from the last. So my linked list, yeah, there is no linked list, and from the last, like, if suppose my n was 2, then from the last my second node was 6, so I have to find this. So by considering this approach, I am also taking two pointers. Let my A pointer and B pointer, initially both of them are pointing to head, but what I did was I started B pointer before, and I moved B pointer at a distance of k from A pointer, or you can say two nodes ahead of A pointer. So A is initially ahead and B is initially at 3, means I am moving, initially both were ahead, but now I am moving B to 3 and A to, A is pointing to 1 only, we are not moving A. So yeah, as my A pointer is here and B pointer is here, so now I am moving both these pointers by one step each simultaneously. So after this, my B pointer is suppose here and my A pointer would be here. Now my B pointer, my B pointer is at 5, my A pointer would be at 3. And similarly, when my B pointer is here, my A pointer would be here. So after 7, when B is at an, after that obviously when I will move, so B would become null, it would become null, so A would be at 6. So wow, amazing. Actually, this is my required node from the last. You can say it is the second node from the last. So what I mean to say is, when B pointer becomes null, the node at which A is pointing would be my required answer, or you can say my required node, because both of them were initially at a distance of 2 nodes from each other. So when we are moving both of them simultaneously, and when the B becomes null, so A would obviously be at the nth node from the end, because they were both moving at same speed, or you can say they were moving simultaneously one step ahead. So this problem was actually this approach, you can say I got this idea from these two runners approach, you can say, like both, like we have seen that both of them were moving at same speed and B runner started before. So and every point of movement, you can say the difference of distance between them was k. So similarly here also, at every point, the difference between the nodes, you can say that B was two nodes ahead of A always. So when B becomes null, so A was at nth node from the end. A was at So yes, that was a pretty simple approach. And why this approach was better than the previous two approach that we have seen, the array one and the direct linked list traversal also, because in both those approaches we were to find the length of the whole linked list, but here no need to find the length, just iterate both of them one step ahead, and yeah, when b becomes null, we get the answer in a node. So it is a little faster, you can say, and yeah, space complexity order of one and time we have just traversing order of n, perfect approach. I think this is the perfect approach for this question. So yeah, I hope this is clear. So let us now move towards the implementation of this approach, or you can say the code part. Okay, so yeah, that's my code. As I told you before also, in GMG we have to complete this function only, get nth node from the last. So we were given the head pointer and the nth node, n value, that which node we have to find from the last, so that value is n. Yeah, so what I did was, initially I count or n whatever, I took the last node two, as I took the two node A and B in the example, I am taking the first and last here. So I will initialize last node with head, and I am moving the last node at a distance of, you can say, n nodes from the head, and I will take first pointer first on head. So I'm moving the last node at a distance of n nodes from the first one. So this is my count. So if suppose my count is greater than n, so obviously, as I told you before also, when my n is greater than the size of the linked list, then this case has not significance, because how would we, you know, kind of find the 11th node when there are only 10 nodes from the last? So in that case would return -1, but as we are not finding the size of linked list here, so this case, how we can, you know, kind of find this case is, we can just take this count, and if after this loop, suppose my last is null but my count is still remaining, like my count is 11 but my length is 8, so obviously I would be getting my count 3 after this loop. So because I have three nodes extra, so in that case my count is greater than 0 and my last is null, so obviously in this case I would return -1. So yeah, otherwise if it's not the case, my count would be 0 if my count is 0 and last is null. So okay, that is a perfect case. So in this case I will take first on the head one and last is at a distance of you can say n nodes from the starting. So yeah, I will iterate both these nodes simultaneously. Now when my last becomes null, so in that case my answer would be in the first node, so I will return the first node's data. Okay, pretty simple approach. Just this was a little tricky section, you can say. When my count is greater than 0, I would return -1 and last equal to 1, obviously. Yes, little bit tricky one, but yeah, it's still easy approach. Okay, I hope I was clear. So, okay, guys, thank you very much.